So this is Matt, and where are we, Matt?
We're at the Royal Exhibition Centre in Carlton in Melbourne.
And what have we got in front of us here?
It's a beautiful fountain. We'll walk forward, have a closer look. We've got the four pillars rising up. We've got two basins, and these beautiful Australiana going on there, a big kitch, especially the kangaroos.
Yeah.
The nice couple, their little Joey coming out.
Yep.
And also the pair of emus, which normally have water gushing out of them, but not at the moment, sadly.
Right. Oh, yeah. Little, like, gargoyle emus there.
Yeah, sort of.
They're actually gargoyles. Yeah. And they're like astral faces as well.
Yes, I guess so. Yeah, and it's interesting also that, you know, they face east and we're on Nicholson Street. And I also suspect that there is some kind of special sun symbology going on here. I also think it's a very significant place because this is where Federation was all formalised at the Melbourne Exhibition Centre.
Right.
In Carlton. Yeah, it's a beautiful building. It's part of Melbourne, you know.
Yeah.
And when we were kids, it was a big deal to come to the Exhibition Centre. It was either the car show was on or the boat show. For Melburnians, this is a very special place, but also for Australia because, you know, this is where Australia was kind of formalised.
Yep.
At the exhibition building.
We have the circular garden, magic circle I would suggest with the central pillar, and we have the four poles around the outside here. We have the four around the one here. Okay, so in the middle of this fountain is the central pillar, the tree of life, and we have emanations out of that central pillar. Creatures are astrally emerging from the tree of life. You have the foliage there, and the creature coming out. Not only that, there is the lion in here also. The little lion's face emerging out. You can see lion's paws emerging out in other symbology. Another lion's face up here. Astral entities emerging from the central pillar. The grail in the centre, the shell symbology also. Freemasons tell you that sacred symbols come from other dimensions. Freemasons tell you this. In the next live shot coming up, please notice that I'm pretty much in the centre of the Royal Exhibition Building of Melbourne. As I turn around physically, try to imagine in your mind that I'm in the central pillar and that my body is actually in one position. I'm the mage in the center, but I've come up through the chakras. I now have four astral faces, one looking out each side, looking down the four corridors of this building, which makes a cross. Indeed, if we look up around there, we will see various sylphs, and indeed included up there, we have the sylphs of the four seasons. Now, indeed, when perhaps summoned, the sylphs of the four seasons, for example, would perhaps appear as an apparition within one's astral sight to one direction. Now, there would be other aspects to the building, but for now, let's just leave it at this and go to the footage. And just remember that such buildings like this are erected at the behest of the most powerful people within society. So up here we have the goddess relating to summer, and then we have the goddess relating to autumn, and then winter. And then spring. The flowers of springtime right there. So corresponds to the four elements, four winds, etc. Part of the symbology. And there is much of it here. We have red hues and green hues and yellow hues and blue predominance around here as well. Virtues, human virtues as well, masonry. Up to this we have the chicken floor, perhaps alluding to the chicken floor right there. The design up here perhaps relating to Isis, Isis right there. For example, the foliage with the horn of plenty kind of coming out of the foliage in a way. four faces up here that go around the four cartouches with the face. And also up here we have the water depicted also. So the waters of the heavens depicted on the rafters here in the Royal Exhibition Centre. Sun windows. Okay, the Royal Exhibition Centre of Melbourne, and we have the fountain here, and we'll look at the plaque, and we can see 1880 on there, and I'll just scan quickly through the plaque, and just to say, yeah, we have the virtues on here, like the sciences, commerce, trade, industry, etc., various other things in here, reference to mer people, children, cherubs, really. We're just going to have a quick look. So that would be the shell on the top, perhaps a reference to the sun. This is like the sun well. This is the tree also. This is also the pillar. So you have the person as the pillar, dovetailing to the foliage, to the tree, the person and the tree, that central pillar. And here you have the magic circle, the four around the central pillar, the four around the one, the little cherubs there. You can see one here is relating to Mercury with the little wings on the helmet. Various platypuses and reference to elemental creatures assisting in the ritual edifice here. And then various sort of mer people here, gods depicted down below. And we've got a bit of a metamorphosis here with the creature, with the fish and the human figure, sort of mermaid type setup. So the birds coming out, we have the lions in here straight. You've got the logo of the Lions Club, the astral faces appearing out of that. So they would be emerging out and kind of coming out, guardian lions coming out, morphing out of that central pillar. You'll see the paw and so forth. So just a bit of a look at that here in Melbourne. This configuration, the kind of central pillar, whether intentional or not, if I do a 180 from this building, we basically turn around and it's in alignment here with the exhibition centre, and we just looked at this fountain here, so it's directly aligned with the exhibition centre here. What else do we have here in the park? We have the
Basically, we've got the fountain, we've got this central triangle shape with a centre pathway.
So over this way there's a pathway, and over that way.
Terminate at the entrance to the park on each side. Some people say that the path was called Illumination Path, yet to lock that down.
This path here?
This pathway heading towards the fountain into the Royal Exhibition Centre.
Illumination Path?
Illumination Path, I can't recall exactly where I read it, it was published on the internet somewhere. Yet to back that up though with some more accounts.
Whether it's official in any way or not, the illumination path is a very apt term. So the mason, for example, would progress up that path. They would get to the fountain, to the interdimensional pillar, of which they would perhaps become a part, but there are various rituals. So the pathway leads to the fountain. You have the same configuration at Canberra. You have the same configuration also in Washington, D.C. In Washington, D.C., you have the dome behind. You also have the dome behind in Carlton Gardens also. This would represent a particular configuration of light. In Canberra, you have the pyramid. This would also represent a variant configuration of light within the magic ritual edifice, I would suggest.
Okay, this is the Royal Society of Victoria. It's a real unknown sort of gem in Melbourne. It sits on basically a Pythagorean-inspired triangle on a wedge in between these busy streets. This is where Burke and Wills launched their mission to the centre of Australia, started from here. I also believe that when they perished, they were brought back and they lay in state here. You can attend lectures here of all different scientific things.
The windows are blocked out up there.
Yeah, they certainly are. All the way around the building, there's some windows are blocked out on the upper level, some on the lower level, quite randomly in some spots.
Right. This is a druidic dolmen, a druidic altar, believed to be an altar. And here in front of the Royal Society of Victoria. We have this stone which was brought from Antarctica, and we have the arrow pointing south to the South Pole there. The stone is orientated, so it's very druidic. They've put it on three legs there, sort of perhaps an occult aspect to this stone here outside the Royal Society here.
The Royal Society of Victoria, the Royal Society, formerly the Invisible College, possibly founded by Francis Bacon.
The Invisible College. The gates to Chinatown here, and amongst the symbology, just to note on this occasion that with the pillars, you kind of have the ferals at the bottom of the pillars here. Quite interesting astral, I would suggest. We have the three gates here. We also have the, like the gargoyles, we have the astral entities up here, the dragons, in Chinatown. Etheric fire from the dragon's mouth, etheric water from the gargling gargoyle's mouth. From the mouth. From the mouth. From the mouth. From the mouth. Just briefly, on the corner of Elizabeth Street here in Melbourne, and this is Little Collins Street here, we have this spooky kind of looking building here. This building reminds me of the so-called witches' houses of Annandale, Sydney. Spooky kind of looking building here, but just a few things. We have the pillars on here, and we have the astral lions coming out of the pillar, emerging out with the veil there also, coming sort of through that veil in a way. And various other things on this building. Looking further on this building, we can see lions emerging from the foliage. Lions emerging from the foliage.
Lions emerging from the foliage.
We can see lions emerging from the foliage. From the mouth of the lions, we can see an output. Now, this would essentially be astral light, I would deeply suspect. Indeed, we see much indication of this elsewhere also. You have the pillars, which are the trees. You can see how they kind of form into the tree there, the tree of life, through the grail, holy grail, and yeah. You have the pillars, which are the trees. You can see how they kind of form into the tree there, the tree of life. Here on Collins Street in Melbourne, we have this mosaic put up here in 1933 by Napier Waller. And among the symbology here, you have the square on this side and the compass on this side. Of interest, if we look carefully up here, you can see participants, and I would suggest in the ritual situation, you have the hair turning to fire there. The figure here is imbued with the element of fire as part of the ritual situation, and we would have perhaps water and earth up there as well. This figure here has the yellow on, perhaps an indication of air, so perhaps air, maybe water, fire, and earth there, something like that. Another figure kind of looking on the earth here. You can see the elements, fire and water there in particular, and then various other detail in there. We're not going to go right into all of this. If we look up here, we can see Egyptian, the eye, of course, compass, and so forth. Looks like the grail up there with, again, the element of fire coming through the grail. That's the central pillar of the ritual edifice. Fish coming down, that fish symbology coming down. Star at the top, linking to the star, and so forth. Main figure up here with the crown chakra lit up. And, yeah, the writing, I'll put a girdle round about the earth. on this building over here, we have the lions coming down, linked to the green, the archways here. But right now we're going to go across and have a look at this building over here. Okay, so up in the building here, we have the god Pan. You have the Saturnian moon Pan. So this would be an entity formation of an entity, a Saturnian entity, the god Pan. And this lady or man here with the symbols, the harp also, so the creation of vibration here on this building, decorative building. Also up here is the, what I would suspect is the goat. You can see the eye, the nose, the horns coming out. An interesting depiction. The waters perhaps there with lily leaves or lotus leaves on it. Howie House. So just looking across, and on the other side, we'll just have a quick look at the lion up here. So the lion and the portal with a link, perhaps the reference to the sun, and down to this building here, and that's the mural right there. Okay folks, this concludes part one. Find the link in the description box for part two.